Okay. Hello. Sorry, I was posting to Instagram really quick that I was going live. And I'm going to say good. I can't type because my keyboard is in a weird place right now. You can hear it and feel it shaking my camera. It's on the edge of the desk at the moment. Work. So, I actually started painting a little while ago, just because I wanted to get myself into like the groove of it. So I'm probably gonna have to put more paint out of my palette soon as is. But what I did off stream was I just kind of fleshed out. Well, I added more background so I could flesh this stuff out. But I'm fleshing out the last couple outer polyps before it kind of goes behind the shrimp, and then all of the stuff is gonna be blurry. And what I kind of did already, you can't really see because it's at the bottom, but down here in this little tiny corner, I just started to like color out. Getting something to look blurry but accurate is a little weird. What I had to do is I actually had to build a pretty solid structure and then just go over it to blur it out of existence. You can't, like, start blurry, I guess you could say. I mean, you kind of can. You kind of get, like, the larger blurry shapes that really have no definition and are just kind of light bouncing. That's a little easier. Like, this part was a lot easier. This part had to have structure. And even now, I'm seeing that it's a little bit too harsh. So I'll go over this. But again, all of this is so much of this is underpainting as it is, because I'm going to have to go over a lot of it. So I'm just going to continue on this area up here with my outermost polyps that are still in focus. And then the shape that kind of goes on at the moment is this is like the farthest out. And then it creeps in. So like right here, this line is the edge of the most in focus polyps. Then there is this like lobe, which are slightly in focus polyps. So this is probably gonna be the trickiest area up at the very top of the painting, which I'm pointing out, but again, you can't say. So this lobe up here is the next closest, but it's just not in focus. But it's still defined. So this is probably gonna be the trickiest lobe. I may leave this till last. I may go and what I may do is, so I've got in focus here, which is my biggest in focus part, and then secondary focus, tertiary focus, background. But what I may do is I may go primary focus, background, tertiary, and then secondary focus. Because there's a weird period of kind of like that. You're looking for a gradation, essentially, in focus, which is tricky. And just much like gradation in color and light, you want to get your endpoints, your darkest and your lightest. I still don't actually have my darkest on here. My darkest areas are here, here, and here. But I do need to actually darken those up, which I'll do so with the burnt sienna. But not now. We're still working on putting these polyps in and just getting some more definition out there, just so that I have the rest of the most in focus. Oh, I forgot. There is another secondary. So there's two secondaries. There's a first secondary lobe up here, which is a secondary focus. But then there's also this secondary focus out here. So there's this little lobe, which is the partner, because this kind of like goes behind where it's focused. And this kind of like, it moves out and around. So this is also not in focus, but in focus. So the secondary blur. Primary, secondary, tertiary, background. Those are our quadrants, our areas, our focus and non-focus points. So I'm going to stop talking and start painting again before my paint gets too dry on my palette. Because it did take like a 20-minute break in between just to get more coffee, and lunch. And my coffee is delicious. So, yeah, enjoy your afternoon. You know, all this time I've been talking, literally nothing has been on the screen because you've been looking at the starting soon screen. I'm glad I don't actually have any viewers at the moment. So if you're watching this back, I apologize. This is what I've been talking about. That entire, for the past 7 minutes of my stream being active. So. Just to recap, if you've all just skipped to where you could start seeing the painting and realize that, oh no, I can't see the painting. Hi, this is the painting. I did start painting already. So here's where I started painting. I was just talking about primary, secondary, tertiary focus. So primary focus is this. Secondary focus, which is a big lobe up at the top here. Secondary focus, which is also down here behind this primary focus. Tertiary focus is all the way up in the upper right corner, left corner, and then background. And then, of course, the other primary focus is our shrimp. But shrimp goes in last. Or at least... We'll get to shrimp. We'll get to shrimp. Until then, now we're gonna paint. Goodness gracious. 1 minute recap for 7 minutes of me rambling on in the starting soon screen. Although I do realize that there's a good portion of that was also me posting to Instagram, so whatever. All right, I'm painting.
perception of self. Benwave isn't necessarily a thing you achieve. Rather, it is a state of mind which you constantly strive toward. This all comes from an understanding that ideas aren't static, but fluid, like water. Be like water. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. I'm going to take a short break because I need to put more paint out on my palette because it's getting really gummy and dry. And I want to get more coffee. So I'll be back in 5. I'm back. Although I haven't put more paint out, but I got my coffee and I went to the bathroom, so that's dry enough to do that then. So I really didn't use a lot of yellow, so I don't want to put yellow out. I do use a lot of scarlet though. In fact, this is my last tube of scarlet acrylic, and it has to go for the rest of the painting, so moderation. Luckily, I don't need a lot of scarlet. It's amazing how far a red will go. Because they are, of course, they're the strongest, most vibrant pigment in my kit. What am I looking for here? What you need to take out with this? Come on. Hard to get you out when you're out in a tube. And I don't have a little scoopy. That'll do. I had a tissue for wiping off paint. Here we go. Never mind putting too much white out, because of all the paints, I have so much white paint. I have a whole tub of white mixing paint that is my backup white paint, because I actually don't like the white mixing paint. It's slightly less vibrant. I like the titanium white, which honestly, you really shouldn't use titanium white for mixing, but I do. I like the vibrancy. I like how strongly it pushes through the paint. Mixing white does just lighten. But I'm particular. Is that all I need right now? Oh, the orange, which is not actually orange. It's a vermilion. But it's orange. Only a little bit, though. And then... probably too much, but... it adds the transparency. That's my slow dry blending fluid. Helps a little bit. Mix. I try to only mix lightly, especially when I'm using a palette that has existent paint puddles on it. Because even though this is for the most part dry, there's still some moisture underneath. If I go too much and I break through those layers, I can pull some of the gummier paint out and mix that in, and then it just, bleh, it bubbles. Oh, no, stop dripping. They're kind of like that. But this paint is fine. I find it interesting how some pigments can handle different viscosities and reabsorb them better than others, which is just, of course, the materials that are going into the pigment that are mixed into the binder, which creates the paint. And warm colors are much more forgiving. I find that I can get them very, I can re-moisten them pretty easily. Because this is a big patch of burnt umber that's been on my palette since the beginning. And it's still kind of moist, whereas everything else is dried up. So like the darker the warm colors are, the more they seem to just last in moisture. Same time, that means they dry slowest. They tend to be the tackiest. Or what I perceive as the tackiest when I have to wait for them to dry. There we go. All right. Fresh paint, more paint's on me. More coffee in the big cup. I'm gonna mute and paint more, and hopefully I can. My goal for today, at least in the next 50 minutes or so, is I want to finish out the primary focus, at least like just penciling in all of the polyps that should be there. Goals. All right, I'm muting again.
talent there.
Oh, I thought you'd see, though. I was a model back in Texas.
Oh, today was an unusual day. But after this, there'll be no more distractions.
Thank you.
I'm going to stop for now because my paint is getting gummy again. I did remove two big polyps up here because I didn't like how they were sitting. And there's actually... They should be... They're in focus, but I didn't have them placed correctly or sized correctly. So I just have to readjust them, especially bringing in these outside ones. So this is the outside edge of all of the most in-focus polyps for this side. There is a little more down here that is in focus, but it blends really weirdly with one of the secondary mounds. So the secondary mound is here, and there's another secondary mound up top, which are... the secondary ones in focus, or they're not quite in focus. And I want to deal with those later, because those are going to be really tough, because they have to be somewhat detailed so that you can see that they are in fact more polyps in the background, but at the same time they are in the background, or they're starting to become part of the background, so they are not in focus. So those two portions will be the secondary, the tertiary, which is pushed back even further. And then all of this behind the shrimp is the farthest background and the most blurred out, which is really just impressions of color. So I'll block those in. Now, the shrimp actually overlays this part of the polyps. So a lot of this stuff is actually going to go away once I put the shrimp back in. As you can see, like, that's the remnant of his eye, and so his mouth comes out farther, and he's got antenna, but because he's sitting in front of them, and I say he, but it's a she, she's pregnant, she's also somewhat transparent, so I want to make sure that anything that should be behind her is set behind her the way it looks, so that once I put her in, I can make the adjustment to how they'll look through her. And know exactly where they are in the picture. Makes more sense for me. It makes more work for me in the end. But I tend to do these how I see them building in my head rather than what would be most... what would make the most sense. But I'm pretty pleased so far with how the polyp stems are starting to really pop out now. But I'm getting the rest of the polyps in, so you can kind of see stem, and then here too, there's a stem, another stem here. So they're starting to, where you can see where it's coming out of, like, an actual structure beneath. Yeah. So, that's it. I'll be back again on Friday. I may, if I get, antsy about painting, I may do another stream in between now and Friday, which will likely be unannounced, so if you're not following, please do follow so that you get the notification when I go live on Twitch. Thanks. Other than that, have a great evening, and I'm gonna go get some dinner and relax for a little bit. Trying to get it so you can see it straight on, since of course you're all seeing it at an angle. You can kind of see it there. Sorry about the glare. All right, cool. I'm gonna go wash my paintbrush as well. Slowly destroying this round of paintbrushes, but that's what happens. You guys have a great night. Thanks for watching. Bye.